Hi everyone, so in today's video I'm going to be attempting to do two different hairstyles using hair rollers. For the sake of the video, I'm just going to do half of my hair straight and the other half wavy, and I'm going to be using the sleep styler hair rollers. So this is what they look like. These are the large rollers. They come in a pack of 8 and they come in this really nice clear bag with a gold zipper, which I really like. These are meant for long and thick or curly hair. They do sell a pack of smaller rollers. It's a pack of 12 for the same price, and it's for people with short hair or people with finer hair. So these look a bit different than regular rollers because A, they are microfiber on the outside. I love the microfiber material because it absorbs water more quickly. So I'm using this with great optimism because I'm hoping that the microfiber material on the outside is really going to soak up and absorb all of the water that's left in the hair, and therefore will have less frizz in the end. What also makes this different is it has memory foam rolls inside. This would just make it feel like a pillow when you're sleeping on it. And you can of course take it out and wash the outside if you want to wash them. So I washed my hair maybe 3 hours ago. So this is my hair after a wash. I still haven't brushed it out. I have naturally curly but really, really frizzy hair. The frizz is my biggest problem no matter what I'm doing. No matter what heatless process I decide to do with my hair each day, it's still going to be really frizzy. That's my biggest struggle. So that's why I'm like really excited about this, because of the microfiber situation I talked about already. I've heatlessly styled my hair every single way that you could possibly do it. I've gotten like a big donut bun, put it on top of my head, put the hair through it. I've done it with straws. I did that on my channel. I do twist braids, regular braids, whatever it is that you can think of, I've done it. I'm going to be comparing the results with regular braids because regular braids are free. Using them to straighten hair, I'm a little bit skeptical about, especially for my own hair texture, because I just don't have really fine hair. So once your hair is brushed out, you can apply whatever styling products you want. I'm going to be applying a styling cream. This is by Fakai. Just going to apply about this much. When I put it in my hair, when I'm blowing it out, I put way less than this. Little bit more. Just because it's a heatless style, I put a little bit more. My nails hurt because I just took off acrylic after having it on for so long, and my nails just keep on breaking and they're a hot mess. They hurt and some of them look like crap, so pardon me. The next product that I'm going to be putting in is a serum. This is just an argan oil vitamin E hair serum by a hairstyler. I love this serum so much. Whenever I heatlessly style my hair, it's usually more successful when there's a lot more product in my hair just to, you know, calm down the hair. So now I'm just gonna separate my hair. I'm just gonna use this. Is that? That's good enough. Just using crocodile clips for this, and I love crocodile clips because they expand with the amount of hair that you have in the clip, which I love. Start out with the first section, and I'm gonna pick a section about this big. Now, what I'm doing and the technique that I'm using is the same technique that I would use with a curling wand. So this is my curling wand. If I was going to grab my hair and curl it, I would take the curling wand and I would do this, right? To give me the curl that I want. This is pretty much the same shape, so I'm going to be treating it the same way. So what you want to do when you're putting it on is make sure that the strap is at the top, not at the bottom. It has to be at the top. You want to hold it pretty taut so it doesn't slip off. So because the hair is going out, I'm going to go in with the strap and just kind of tie it around. Okay. I don't think this is going to be enough. Should the pieces be bigger? So I use 6 on this side, so I need 12 if I'm going to do them like properly. I would need 12. So I use too many on this side, so I'm gonna separate out these two, and I'm gonna put them in one. I'm gonna take these out and put these together as well. See what happens when you have a bigger piece, because if you want to do smaller pieces, one pack of these may not be enough. And I don't know, you guys, if unless I get some amazing curls, I don't know if I would buy two packs of these. These are pretty expensive. The only way I can see myself buying two packs is if I get incredible curls, because it would be almost around the same price as a curling wand, except this is a heatless way, so your hair wouldn't be damaged. So I have four left. I'm gonna try to do the straight with four. So now I'm attempting the straight side. So what I'm going to do is just brush out my hair. You're gonna take it again with the strap at the top. I already have like my baby hairs doing their thing. You're gonna just hold the hair straight and parallel to the roller instead of bringing it around like we did with the waves. Keep it really close to the scalp if you can. As close to the scalp as possible. I'm as close as possible. I'm like right up here. Truthfully, you guys, I wouldn't sleep in these. They're not uncomfortable, but they're just annoying. So I have a perfect amount for two more. Last bit. They are squishy, so if you sleep, they're not going to be uncomfortable to sleep on, I assume. I'm just not gonna sleep on them. It's 9:30 right now. I will come back at 12:30, around 12:30, to see what has transpired. We know I'm skeptical about this, so if this gives me really, really nice waves, I don't mind, you know, washing my hair maybe at 6, taking it out right before bed, and going to sleep with nice waves. It's just another heatless style. I'm a huge fan of heatless styles, and I'm always trying the new ones, so I had to try this one. It's not a sleep styler for me, but we will see. Usually when I'll do another heatless style, sometimes it'll be a braid. It'll usually be a braid. It'll sometimes get too tight and it'll give me a headache and it'll feel like it's pulling on my scalp. With these, I don't have that feeling. They also feel very light. They don't feel heavy on the head, which I like. This method that I did right here is not the only method that you can use to curl your hair with these. You can do it so many different ways to get different kinds of curls. If I do like it, then I would continue to try every single method of curling with these, because why not utilize all that it has to offer? So maybe if I do like it, I'll post another video showing you guys the different ways that you can curl your hair with it. If it works out, we'll see. So I just finished Rules of Engagement. I'm very sad about it, very sad about it. I'm starting up with Baby Daddy again because I've watched all the seasons. There's a new season. What did I just finish? Oh, I just finished Shooter, so good. I'm all over the place. I have really intense shows that I watch, but then I also have really chill shows, and right now I'm in like chill mode. All right, I'll see you in a bit. So we are back. I'm going to take these out. Okay, that's not bad at all. They slide right out. It's not bad at the bottom, but it's very hard to get really close to the root. I couldn't get so close to the root and straighten it at the same time. It's a lot easier to get closer to the root when you're doing waves. So I personally would not opt for these to straighten my hair, but I feel like if you have finer hair than mine, this may actually work for you. This is not bad though. What I'm thinking is if I take like this part of my hair, I'll take this curly piece too. You can see the little curls. Do you guys see that at the top? But this is the part that's really visible. If we can just keep the bottom of our hair heatless like this, that's not bad. I'm thinking if I blow dry this, it may look a lot better. So I'm gonna go and just blow dry this so we can see if we can get away with it. feel like it looks really good now. Maybe I would do like the back, just because I feel like the back pieces would really need it. But I'm figuring this is really good, especially if you want your hair to grow. Oh, by the way, I just wanna say, I used the heat after I took these out. There is a warning on the instructions that come with these. I know a lot of people like to toss out the instructions. So if you're one of those people, I am here to tell you, do not put these in your hair and then blow dry over them. But back to this, once I blow dried the top, it no longer looks kinky. It looks actually really smooth and nice now that I touched it up. I can see this saving you time if you just have to blow dry like a few pieces rather than your whole head. I would go out like this. It's really not bad. This is the straightest that I can ever get my hair heatlessly. I'm just putting more of my hairstyler hair serum that I put in earlier. So this is the straight side. So now, this side. This side doesn't come out as easily, so I'm gonna just undo this. That's really pretty. See what I'm talking about? Like, I can't get these waves out of a braid no matter how hard I try. I feel like you have to have really long hair. This is the kind of wave that I would get only out of a curling wand, which is why I was excited to use these, because when I saw the waves coming out, this is what they look like. And these are curling wand waves in my opinion, at least to me they are. So I'm just gonna keep going. So this one didn't come out as good. This was like the bigger piece where I had to put a lot of hair because there weren't enough rollers. That's how this one came out. So that's definitely something to keep in mind, and I wish there were more rollers, especially for 40 bucks. So this is what it looks like without anything, without me touching it. So you can see there's like kink. Let me try to fix it. I'm gonna just run my fingers through it. I can go in with a curling wand and just fix the top. Ooh, look at that. So this I would fix. It actually says it on the instructions. It says that sometimes you could get a kink in your hair. It would just look a little funky, and if that happens, you can just fix it and touch it up with a curling wand or a flat iron. It made my hair super big, which I like. I only like it because I would only do heatless styles to grow out my hair. If you're just somebody that doesn't like to use heat, then you would really have to practice with these, and I think you would just get a lot better in placing them and just knowing which way to do it. I'm gonna kind of just smooth it out. I feel bad that I had to like touch them up, but let's put some serum on this. Just, but my hair feels so soft at the bottom, so nice. I only had to touch up what, 2-3 pieces? Not bad at all. I don't think that's bad. I mean, it may be bad for the price, but again, if you have a hair growth journey, then it may be worth it to you. It all depends on your perspective on it. So that's it for this video. I do like both sides. I would keep going back in here. I still feel like this needs to be lifted a little bit. These are the waves that I've been searching for so long. They look styled. They look like actual curling wand waves, and they're heatless. So I really love the waves. The straight hair, I would not go for this. I can definitely blow dry my own hair and have it. I like, when I do my hair straight, I like it to look sleek and shiny. This isn't like the straight that I would go for, but it did work. So if you're somebody that has a different hair texture than mine, and if you're somebody that has finer hair, this will 100%, you may love it. I like it. I don't love it. I probably would never do it myself unless I was just really, really lazy. I mean, I don't really see myself really doing it, because I'd rather do this if I was really lazy. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. As always, I really appreciate it. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not already, and I will see you guys in my next one.